The speaker's remarks were in response to recent pronouncement by the United States that imposed visa ban and travel restrictions on 348 members of parliament and their immediate family members to the United States of America for voting in favor of the Anti-Homosexuality Act. Among noted that she is unbothered by the sanctions because Uganda has got everything she needs to live.
I want to thank the President of the Republic of Uganda for really assenting to that law. Some people thought that the president was not going to assent to the law. I am proud and happy with what the president did. We will continue protecting the family. We will continue protecting the family, protecting the rights of our children and our country, and we will not live in handouts.
Legislators asked Ugandans opposed to the Anti-Homosexuality Act to leave the country and relocate to nations like the United States and the UK, where such values are embraced. They reiterated their position in supporting the bill that is attracting backlash.
Those who don't want that law, let them leave our country. They go and live in UK, they live in London, they live in US, or wherever they want to live. But this law, we are going to protect it with our blood, with our sweat and our souls. There is a lot of pressure, there is a lot of intimidation. And I have engaged them. These forces, I have engaged them. Because they have come to my office from Britain, America, and the rest. They are looking for allies. Allies to promote that immorality in this country.
Ministers turned against the National Unity Platform President Robert Kyagulanyi for fueling sanctions against government officials. David Bahati, the Minister of State for Industry, described statements made while on BBC last week as reckless, saying President Museveni did not influence any member of parliament to vote in favor of this law.
The law that we passed against homosexuality was a law that we believe in. We believe in our values. We know that there are a number of black males that are being traded around. For example, Madam Speaker, now, in addition to restriction on visas, they have also threatened to cut AGOA, which is a program that we have been implementing with the Americans.
It's very unfortunate, Right Honourable Speaker, that we have one of our own, at a very high level of leadership, a president of a political party in the country, and the head of a party in opposition in this parliament, that still moves an extra mile to provoke these homosexuals against Uganda to create more of this pressure. That's why you are looking
Thank
at this
action.
We make laws on behalf of Ugandans and the honorable colleagues. Nobody should feel intimidated. And
Thank
also,
you.
Our friends, advise your leaders of the parties. Yes, you may want to talk sweet so that you get money from homosexuals, but I don't think that's correct.
In May this year, Parliament passed the Anti-Homosexuality Act with a maximum penalty of death on aggravated homosexuality. The bill was introduced by the Bugiri Municipality legislator, Asman Basalirwa. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.